Hi, my name is Mel, an Australian ceramicist located in the Hunter Valley of New South Wales. In the year 2022, my family and I decided to pack up a home along with my studio on the Central Coast and move 45 minutes up the road to wine country to build my dream studio where I can teach the art of ceramics. This dream has been in the works for a very long time, and I can't wait to share the journey with you along with my crazy family.
I've just walked in the door. I've been away for the weekend in Sydney, and the bisque firing. It's nice and toasty warm in there. Can't see any damage so far, but we'll let them cool down for a little bit longer, and then I might unpack. Hello. Yes, Nosy. And look at that, they all survived. There's a little crack on that handle, but I think that should be all right with when I glaze them. But no explosions, they all survived. They're going to look great after I glaze them. I'm going to show you the comparison of after shrinkage. Like when people attend my workshops, they go, oh, that's a really big mug. But you got to think about the shrinkage, like to take in consideration that that is a pretty big mug and it's quite heavy. But after I glaze it and fire it, it turns into that. And I think that's a pretty good, decent sized mug. It's crazy, hey? Now that turns into that.
Hey, coming along? The idea is coming to life.
It is so cold. I haven't been in my studio for the last, I don't know, 4 days because it's just been so cold. I haven't even got my garage door open and I'm wearing my husband's jumper to keep me warm. But this is where my studio is and I need to do stuff. I have a workshop tomorrow and Thursday. I forgot to share with you how my actual workshop went with my Sunnyfield, with my people that have disabilities. I'll show you what they actually made. Look at that. They made like little planter bowls. So I got them to make a little bowl first and then they put some feet at the bottom. I had a couple of helpers there, but they do majority of the work. I think they did a really good job. Some of the feet have come off, but I'm hoping I can fix that with some glaze after. Yeah, they look great. And then I've got another one Thursday with them. So every Thursday. I've been booked in for a team building workshop tomorrow at the Hunter Valley. So I've got around about 12 people. So I need to do some clay prep for that and also pack. And then some more clay for Thursday as well, which every Thursday I'll be working with Sunnyfield, the disability service, in at Singleton. So I'll roll out some more clay for that. We are going to do some kind of monster mouths. I wonder if I can find the stuff. Here they are. I found them. So monster mouths. I run these. I do these air dry clay workshops for kids in school holidays, but I thought these are really fun. My girl's making these and I thought these would be just fun to make. Again, you just make a pinch pot and then you kind of curve the mouth down to make the mouth, and then you can attach all your mouth or your teeth and tongues and eyeballs. I thought that would be fun and creative for Thursday for Sunnyfield. And they seem to have fun and they have a little bit more mobility with their arms. So they can actually roll out a lot of things, which is really good. So we can get more creative compared to last year's group that I had. So yeah. Finally have the garage door open just because I was packing stuff. So I was working up a bit of a sweat. Look at my dog. No, he keeps looking up. He keeps looking up there. What's up there? Hopefully not a rat. What is it? Something's keeps looking up there. What's going on? What is it? What is it? Look at his face. Yeah, you're loving that mud, aren't you?
Look at him. He's an absolute mess.
You're an absolute mess, you are. Sorry, lay down. Down. Oh, yeah, you're loving the mud. You're loving the rain. And here it comes again, more and more. Up there, buddy. All right, I'm going to have to investigate. Hopefully it's not a rat or a mouse hiding in one of my molds. All right, he's making me investigate. I'm a bit concerned. He never acts like this. So there's something. I can't see any rat poo anywhere. I'm hoping it's not a snake, but very unlikely. I'll try to turn these upside down so things don't nest in them, but I have their ways of getting in. Oh, these are heavy.
So my mic decided to die on me, but I did have a look, a really good look up there, and I didn't find anything at all. I don't know what he was looking at. There could have been something there before and it ran away, but there was no signs of rats or mice. So thank God for that. And snakes, it's just way too cold. So I did actually reorganize it. So thank you, Huxley, for making me reorganize my shelves.
Oh my goodness, I almost had a heart attack. It was just this foam thing. It was up the top there on that black box and it flew down. I don't know. I was thinking of maybe flying rats or something. It scared the bejesus out of me. Did you see my soul literally leave my body?
We also got a special delivery this week. We ordered some posts, these beautiful handmade posts that are going to be my entrance feature. So it's going to be an awning just above my studio entrance, and they are so big and chunky, they're going to look so beautiful.
I'm heading just up the road to the Hunter Valley to run a team building workshop. There's about 12 people, a mix of male and females, and they want to kind of just have a free range of just doing whatever they want. So yeah, about to go off to that. Should be a good day, and this is a nice day because it stopped raining.
I'm at Kirkton Park, Voco Kirkton Park in the Hunter Valley. It's beautiful here, it's so nice. But I'm just setting up at the moment. They're just having their lunch break, and then they'll be into Get Create soon. It's so nice here. It's a lovely day.
Look at that beautiful view. So I just finished for the day. Really nice. All done. I just wanted to kind of linger for a bit after pack up and just enjoy just days like this. And look at that. They just went for it. They did such a good job. Didn't even know what they were doing for the day. It was a surprise for a team building activity. And they all made a whole bunch of different things. They're gonna look great.
Another day, another workshop. I'm here at Singleton. It is Thursday, and every Thursday I'm going to be here in the morning running a clay workshop. They've got me set up in their wood workshop where they just, you know, where they do woodwork and all their other kind of crafty kind of things. And I'll set up soon. Today we are making mouth monsters, which I'm really excited about. So hopefully they'll enjoy it. They're just having morning tea and they'll come and join me soon.
And we all are all ready to go. So what we're making, these are just fun because once you've fired them and I glaze them, you can put them in your garden. They can be little things in there.
It's school holidays, so
shark egg, Mum.
We're doing some activities on the lake. It's a beautiful day. That water is absolutely freezing.
We found a shark
I'm surprised egg. My girls can still feel their toes. You found a shark egg?
Yeah.
A shark egg?
Yep.
Okay. But good for our dog, Hux, because he's been just so muddy. So he's had a bit of a wash in the lake. He loves it. Smelling and peeing on everything. It's nice. It's beautiful. Look at him. Loving life he is. In his happy place. He misses the water. Don't you, Hux? You miss it, don't you? And I can hose him off later. We actually like to do family activities through the school holidays, and we surprise the girls by taking them to see Disney on Ice road trip. I highly recommend it.
And pulled up the sky. You were waddling yay high. I'm Olaf. And you are
Olaf?